Welcome to Crime Scene Chronicles.
Today's story is about the beautiful Taliyah Hilliard. She was 19 years old, soon to be 20 in May. Taliyah's story is a tragic one. She was loved by her father, mother, siblings, family, friends, and also her co-workers. Taliyah recently began to get her own place and move out and thrive on her independence. She recently started dating, and then one day she didn't show up for work. So her co-workers thought something's wrong, because Taliyah always come to work. So they went to her home, and then they found the unbelievable.
A convicted sex offender is behind bars tonight, accused of sodomizing a Memphis teen and leaving her dead inside her Fox Meadows apartment. Good evening, and thank you for joining us. I'm Stephanie Skurlock. Greg is off tonight. WREG's Bria Jones has been digging into this case and has more details surrounding the gruesome discovery.
It's been over a month since Taliyah Hilliard was found lifeless inside her Fox Meadows apartment.
She's only 19. She would have been 20 in May. You know, it's my baby. She didn't deserve that. She didn't.
Police say Hilliard's body was discovered on February 10th by a co-worker.
As soon as I stepped out the car, it's like my whole spirit just changed.
Zderica Hopkins says Hilliard, who worked with her as a manager at Family Dollar, was like a little sister. That morning, she says her boss alerted her that Taliyah never came to open the store, raising a red flag.
Anybody that knows Taliyah know that she gonna come to work.
Hopkins says when she got to Taliyah's apartment at the residences at Lakeview, the door was unlocked. Once inside, she says she found her body underneath blankets and pillows.
She was real swollen, her arm was broke. You know, it looked like a little snake.
Even more disturbing, police say she was covered in soap with severe bruises to her upper and lower body, indicating she was sodomized.
And he looked like he might have strangled her, because she was foaming at the mouth.
36-year-old D'Angelo Bridges is facing multiple charges, including first-degree murder, abuse of a corpse, and tampering with evidence. According to the arrest affidavit, detectives used Uber to identify Bridges after surveillance video showed him being dropped off at Hilliard's apartment. They were also able to ping Hilliard's cell phone near this apartment complex on Summer Avenue, where police say Bridges' sister lives. Investigators say a camera caught Bridges tossing a pillowcase in the trash, and he later admitted to being at her home.
All the guy could tell him was they were just hanging out.
Police say Bridges is a convicted sex offender from the Chicago area and currently a registered sex offender in Holly Springs, Mississippi.
And that's the sad part. Like, you know, she didn't know anything about his past, and then that's something that cost her.
Tonight, Bridges is being held here at the Shelby County Jail on a $10,000 bond. He's set to appear in court tomorrow morning.
Investigators brought Bridges in for questioning this week. They discover he's a registered offender out of Holly Springs, Mississippi. He'd been living in Memphis since December, and he never registered with the police department. He's also convicted of an SA offense out of Illinois, which he pled guilty to, predatory criminal SA assault, back in 2011. In this tragic case, he was a stranger she had no idea about. So sad, and condolences to this family going through this such hard time right now of losing their daughter. Young ladies, if you watching this, this is what you do. When you first meet somebody, do it like this. Don't tell nobody where you stay for at least 6 to 8 months. Only go out with them in public places. Don't go to their home. Don't give them any kind of information. Don't tell them where you work at. That's what you gotta do. Because see, a snake is not gonna show itself the first day. They try to slither their way in to get you. So if you just start dating somebody, you're unsure about them, You take your time, get to know them, make sure you're in public places, make sure you're not giving out no personal info. That's all you gotta do. Cause sometimes like people, you know, they come off as friendly and you trust them and we kind of let our guards down. But in this day and age, it's no letting the guards down, especially if you're a female. So don't give out your personal address and let nobody come to your house, no matter how tempting it be. And you know, no matter how cool they may seem, just protect yourself. That's all you gotta do. She didn't deserve this. She was a young lady just learning her independence and just living her life regular. And this guy, if you look at the timeline, he did this like in an hour and 15 minutes. Crazy. Thank God those cameras caught him. But RIP, young lady. I hate this happening to you. This is to bring awareness and bring these stories to light. Rest in peace, Taliyah.
Thanks for watching CSC Gang.